Won't do that again.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Goddamn toe. Oh, from a gun.
We get out, two guys to go upstairs and go to
I'm getting up there.
Sorry,
Jake.
Brody!
What do they want upstairs? Just two dudes, I already got
them
up there.
Over
here. Swing left.
Can you hit that alleyway?
Yes, I can hit that alleyway.
I want you to keep watching the rooftops on that alleyway and down the street, Roger.
Hey, you're going to hit that tank. Fucking, hey, check it out. You're going to hit that fucking pole if you hit that alleyway.
No, that might be.
Not the rooftops. You're all right.
Okay.
Somebody's already hit that motherfucker right there.
That's what I'm saying. He's going to hit that pole.
I got my saw right here.
Saw?
No, a fucking saw.
Oh, okay.
Down there.
The video you just watched took place in Ramadi, Iraq, likely sometime in 2006 during the Battle of Ramadi. Two tanks continuously hammer insurgent positions inside of a Ramadi hotel, demonstrating the sheer destructive power of the M1 Abrams. U.S. forces are behind the camera discussing the engagement, and the tanks use both the coaxial and main gun as a giant FU to anything that's on the other side of it. I like to think the names of these tanks are Abbott and Costello, or maybe even Sonny and Cher. Riggs and Murtaugh, Cheech and Chong, what's your best name that you have for these two tanks? Here's a little bit of background on the Battle of Ramadi. The Battle of Ramadi took place from March 2006 to November 2006 and was fought for control of the Al-Anbar provincial capital, Ramadi. It was a joint operation consisting of U.S. Army, U.S. Marines, SEALs, and Iraqi security forces. Ramadi had been central to the insurgent activity since the fall of Fallujah in 2004. One of the earliest iterations of the Islamic State, still then known at the time as Al-Qaeda in Iraq, had declared Ramadi as its capital. The Battle of Ramadi would eventually take the lives of 94 U.S. service members, 30 Iraqi security forces, and caused over 200 casualties. Fighting in Ramadi was house to house and street to street, and for a period was considered one of the worst places in Iraq to be from a combat perspective. The overarching strategy from the U.S. military leadership included what was known as seize, clear, hold, and build. Forces on the ground would embark from strategic locations directly into the hottest areas of contested territory to take it from insurgents. They'd then clear it, hold it, and build permanent outposts in those locations. From there, the cycle of seizing further stronghold areas, clearing them, holding them, and building additional outposts would leapfrog until the city was cleared. Now, if you'd like to check out more information about the Battle of Ramadi, there are a host of other documentaries and specials dedicated to it, along with a few dedicated to the venerable SEAL Team 3, who were at the heart of a lot of this battle. Now, before we head out, I wanted to drop a note about AR-500's partnership with us. AR-500 was founded on the premise that the Second Amendment protects both arms and armor, and everyone should be afforded the opportunity to purchase and own the means to protect themselves. AR-500's NIJ Level 3 and 4 plates come with an optional build-up frag lock coating to protect and mitigate from spall, and they are well worth the wait. Steel armor has a lot of advantages over ceramic and PE armor from a durability perspective, but AR-500 has other armor types if that's your fancy as well. Use the code FUNKER below for 27% off your order. Make sure you have the app downloaded so you can watch all this footage on the go. Hit the like, hit the sub, hit the bell, and stay informed.